Professor Dave here. Let's learn how to FOIL.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We've learned how to add and subtract polynomials, so now it's time to learn how to multiply them. But before we do this with long expressions, let's start with the tiny ones. First, we can multiply monomials. 2x times 3 is 6x, just the way 2 apples times 3 is 6 apples. 2x times 3x is 6x squared. In this case, the numbers multiply, as do the x's, so that's easy enough as well. Now we have to look at binomials. These are expressions with two terms. If we have a monomial times a binomial, again, this is very simple, because we just apply the distributive property. Looking at 2x times the quantity x minus 4, we just multiply across, so we get 2x squared minus 8x. But if we want to multiply two binomials, things start to get a little less obvious. Take x plus 3 times x minus 2. What we want to understand is that in order to perform this calculation, we would have to distribute each term in one binomial across the other binomial, essentially using the distributive property twice. And a quick way to do this is to apply the FOIL method. These letters stand for first, outer, inner, last, and they instruct us as to which numbers to multiply together and in what order. First means we multiply the first term in each binomial. In this case, x times x equals x squared. Then we do the outer terms, x times negative 2, or negative 2x. Then the inner terms, 3 times x, or 3x. And finally, we do the last terms in each binomial, or 3 times negative 2, which is negative 6. That gives us x squared minus 2x plus 3x minus 6. And we can combine like terms to get x squared plus x minus 6. Again, the reason this works is because it's as though we are distributing each term of one binomial across the other binomial, and the FOIL method just ensures that we do it the same way every time so that we don't make a mistake. The most common error when FOILing is certainly listing the wrong sign for a particular term. Don't get confused by the plus or minus in between the terms of the binomial. Just think of the binomial as a list of two terms, each with a particular sign. When multiplying terms, don't think about whether the terms in the resulting list will be added or subtracted. Just list the result with its sign, whether positive or negative, and the operations will take care of themselves. For example, when we did the x times 2, just assume that this minus sign means negative 2, and when we get negative 2x, we just place it in the list. For 3 times x, we got positive 3x, so just list positive 3x with a plus symbol. At the end, all the operations are there for us to follow, clear as day, so if you use this method, it will be hard to make a mistake. Let's try a trickier one, x squared plus 4 times negative 2x minus 1. These binomials look different than the previous example, but we still just FOIL as usual. For the first term, we get x squared times negative 2x, which is negative 2x cubed. For the outer, since there's a negative 1, we get negative x squared. Then inner, we get negative 8x. And lastly, 4 times negative 1 is negative 4. There are no like terms to combine, so that's the end of it. Now that we can multiply binomials, what happens when we multiply a binomial by a trinomial? As one might expect, it's a little more complicated, but it's essentially the same thing. We could multiply the first term of the binomial across the trinomial, and then the other. For example, x plus 2y times 3x minus y minus 4. First, let's multiply x across the trinomial. That gives us 3x squared minus xy minus 4x. Then we just continue this list of terms by multiplying 2y across the trinomial. That will be 6xy minus 2y squared minus 8y. There are two like terms to combine, the xy terms. 6xy minus 1xy gives 5xy. Then we just list according to convention. X squared, then y squared, then xy, then x, then y, And there we have it. So it's not really any harder as the expressions get bigger, just more steps, since we need to use the distributive property more times. If we wanted to multiply a trinomial by a trinomial, it wouldn't be that hard. We would just end up with 9 terms, and then condense from there if any like terms exist. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.